My name's Antonia, and I'm going to be informing you about type 1 diabetes. So, what exactly is it? It's an autoimmune disease or disorder, depending on who you talk to, that impairs your ability to create the hormone insulin, which helps regulate the level of sugar in your blood. Which, without that, is very dangerous, because either A, your sugars will go too high, thus attacking or damaging your other organs, or go too low and you could faint or fall into a coma, either or. It mostly affects children and young adults, but it's not limited to that category. And it is a permanent disease. You cannot get rid of it. There is no cure for it yet, though we're working on that. Now, it occurs in your pancreas, which is where the hormone insulin and glucose are produced. So what happens in it is your autoimmune system can't recognize your own cells. So it will treat your own cells as an invading species and thus attack it, which mostly happens in the pancreas, thus destroying or damaging your ability to create insulin, thus impairing it, so on. So that's usually how you get the diagnosis of diabetes, is your inability to create or produce insulin. There are treatments for it. Well, not treatments, there are things to help you stay alive with it, which I will hand out. A few materials that you use, but I have like one rule. Don't activate it, you can look at it, just don't push the button or anything. But you can look at it because this stuff is expensive. So this is a kit for checking your blood sugar. This is Novolog, which is a short-term insulin that helps check your blood sugar. Which is literally just a shot of sugar. So you have different insulins like Novolog and Lantus, which is short-term and long-term insulin to regulate your blood sugar. Short-term is usually during the day for checking blood sugars or eating, whereas Lantus is long-term, so most people usually take it at night for when they're sleeping until they wake up. Then with the kit, you just prick your finger and put it on a test strip, which will meter tell you what your sugar level is, but currently I don't use that anymore because I have a continuous glucose monitor in my arm, so I just scan my phone and that will tell me what my sugar is. So there's lots of doctor visits and different changes in your doctor visits, like the eye doctor will dilate your eye every visit, which is annoying because that stuff stings. And you also visit an endocrinologist, which is basically a doctor for diabetes. Now, most people will treat it relaxly depending on how long you've had it, but it's a very serious condition because if you take too much insulin or too little, you could damage your organs, fall into a coma, get ketoacidosis, or die. So it's literally you're doing the work of your organ, which most people take for granted. You don't have to worry about that. So there are ups and downs to it, besides the hovering parents, constant worry. I mean, if you're low, you get to eat during class, which most people point out most of the time is a plus, which it's iffy. It's pain, it's not fun, but there's no other way to go except forward for it. Any questions? Okay, I have one question for you, and if you get it right, you get the entire bag of chocolate. Okay? How many types of diabetes are there? I saw.
Four.
Correct. Two are the most well-known, but there are two more that count as diabetes, but they're not mostly talked about. All right. So that concludes my speech. I hope I haven't traumatized you at all. All right.